Arabic is my mother tongue, but sometimes it gets a little bit too complicated. So my mother and I decided that I needed a tutor. Just last year was the first time she stepped into our house. Her brown eyes filled with mysterious wisdom and her smile a youthful innocence. But little did I know that those very same eyes witnessed war and its atrocities and its tragedy.
She used to tell me stories about her home country. Talk about events that I, as a young Emirati woman, would never imagine going through. Or you, who were privileged enough to not have witnessed the world's misfortunes, could ever imagine going through. On April the 28th, Al-Quds Hospital was bombed by 4 consecutive airstrikes. The next day, the Malakhan Mosque was bombed as well. Aleppo, Halab, in Syria, lost 75 people. And in the span of 3 months, 941 people lost their life to a war they did not pay for. Events that were happening 2,900 kilometers away from me was the reality of someone sitting right next to me, someone who was tutoring me. This ignited an anger that I never thought I had. It unraveled emotions that I never thought I had. I realized how desensitized our world has become to blood, death, and war. How do we get our society to feel again? To empathize with people again? How do we get our world to stop using ignorance as a cloak from the reality beyond them? We need to create a society that can identify problems and then later on solve them. And the way we do this is by evaluating the way we react to things that are happening around us, the events that are happening around us, our surroundings. Our conscious mind, it's like plastic. It stretches and it compresses and it reforms with every new experience you go through, with every new information you absorb. I once asked myself, Moza, why are you you? What made your personality the way it is? And multiple aspects of my life came to mind. My parents, my international community that I'm a part of in school, my religion, the Arab community that I'm a part of, and maybe my classmates as well. The reason we're like this is because our brains develop. They undergo constant metamorphosis. We create new pathways and delete old ones with every new experience we go through, with every new knowledge we acquire. And knowing this, we need to take it into our advantage. Because knowing this gives us evidence that we can be resensitized to the events that are happening around us, to the world that we're surrounded by. We can be changed from watchers and bystanders to changers and doers. But how do we start? Well, we start by absorbing the right information, not using one source, like the media. The media, more often than not, is negative and is manipulative and full of false information. Rather, use people. Talk to people who come from different backgrounds. Talk to people who come from different religions. You will acquire knowledge that you never thought you would ever learn. Absorb new information, the right one. Absorb information like you're walking down a pathway full of people, where you involuntarily glance at them and accept their existence in this chaotic and sad world. Where you be that person that smiles and nods at them. Treat your curiosity about the world in the same way. Treat it in such a way that differences beyond you becomes an extension of you. Treat it in such a way that differences beyond you starts becoming a strength that makes you you. The media tries to align their beliefs with yours all the time, but that's a form of toxicity that we must learn to prevent. Bad people are making the change right now, and I'm sure you can all think of examples. We often affiliate that with government corruption, or corruption in general, where monetary benefits are placed over people. Where monetary benefits are placed over human rights. But as you acquire more information, as you become a knowledgeable individual, you'll find that your perspective of the world will change. Your microscopic view of things will turn into a macroscopic view. And you'll find that your curiosity will be reignited. You will ask more, you will inquire more, you'll inform people more. And you'll be resensitized to the world around you with time. You'll be aware that Syria is suffering, that Yemen is suffering, that Iraq is suffering, that Venezuelans are starving, that minorities in Myanmar are being slaughtered unjustly. I'm not only referring to countries, I'm referring to people, discrimination and bigotry. These constant cries for help that we ignore, we must start responding to. I'll take a moment to accept these bad changes. It's my fault, but it's your fault too. It's all our faults. That is purely because of the lack of communication that's happening around us, the lack of collaboration that's supposed to be happening between us. We don't act in some type of fear of rejection or retaliation from a source unknown, when in reality, we need to use that as a source of motivation. It all starts with connecting an idea with an action. You see, change happens over various factors that shape the world today. Medicine, sciences, mathematics, arts, performing arts, anything you feel like that you feel you can contribute to or be a part of. Robert Kennedy once said, each time a man stands up for an ideal, or acts to improve the lot of others, or stands up against injustice, he sends forth a tiny ripple of hope, and crossing each other from a million different centers of energy, and during those ripples, build a current which can sweep down the mightiest walls of oppression and resistance. He's referring to the butterfly effect. Change is a complex thing, a complicated thing that we'll never be able to wrap our minds around. But there's one thing we know, is that it happens with a reason. And more often than not, it requires a catalyst. And that catalyst could be you, any of you, no matter how old or young you are. Just like how a flap of a butterfly's wing can create a storm, your small action can change the world. Does anyone know Rosa Parks? No? That's unfortunate. Rosa Parks did a little thing, a simple act of not giving up her seat to a white passenger in the colored section of a bus, which then led to her arrest on December 1st, 1955, which then on led to a nationwide effort to end segregation and racism in public facilities. She is now arguably known as the mother of the movement that ended segregation. She refused to give up her seat. That act affects our world today, where all colors can sit together. Explore different possibilities, explore different alternatives, explore different aspects of things that you never thought of before. Allow yourself to be so passionate about something that your hands start shaking, like me right now, that your hands start shaking when you talk about it, that your heart starts beating faster when you talk about it, that you cry in the midst of talking about it. That passion that I'm referring to, everyone has it. Everyone has it, and that passion is what enables you to change the world today. Some stay silent and accept tragedies and refuse to promote development throughout the world. But that's not who you are. You should not stay silent. Some refuse to speak up or do anything. That doesn't mean you shouldn't either. You research and you learn about your stance and your cause. You research and you learn and you solidify and then you utilize, and that can be a weapon of words, and that can be a shield of wisdom. I want you to educate me. I want you to take initiative. You're aware of things. I'm aware of things. I think it's about time that we start exchanging instead of me just standing up and telling you things. Talk. You can talk. You can communicate. You can project what you believe in. Once people are aware about what you believe in or about your cause, the scope of exposure increases and it grows. No one has the same passion as you do. No one has yours. No one can stand up on stage and talk about global warming and about how we need to do something about it like you can. No one can stand up on stage and talk about women's rights or indigenous people's rights and talk about how we need to do something about it like you can. Now I know you have the cure to incurable diseases. You can end poverty in a nation. Now I know the idea of changing the world sounds pretty far-fetched. I mean, I could barely stick to a diet for 2 months. What makes me think that I'm gonna change the world? Well, I'm not passionate about dietary. I'm not passionate about dietary, but what I am passionate about is people and their capabilities, how people don't amount to anything, but to everything. The least you can do is to be aware and to learn. With that, you've done the job for yourself and your community. It all starts with small steps, and the first step you take is to be aware and believe in the potential that you have as an individual. And then on, only then, will the people around you will believe in it too. Take advantage of the social media platforms you have. Take advantage of the school platforms you have. Take advantage of any platform like TEDx today. All these resources that can help you change the world or lead to a change. I think it's about time that we start using it. If you've raised your own awareness, then you've started something beautiful. Now it's up to you whether you want to continue on that journey that leads to that change. Arguably, that could be the hardest thing you ever do in your life, whether that change be small or big. Some stay silent. You should not stay silent.